गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस चैप्टर 12 रेशियो एंड प्रोपोर्शन एक्सरसाइज 12.1 क्वेश्चन नंबर 8। क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 है सीमा इन अ ईयर सीमा अर्न 1,50,000 रुपीस एंड सेव 50,000 रुपीस। फाइंड द रेशियो ऑफ मनी डेट सीमा अर्न टू द मनी सी सेव्स एंड मनी डेट सीमा सेव्स टू द मनी सी स्पेंड। ओके, सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन दिस इज गिवेन दैट मनी सीमा अर्न। ओके, सो व्हाट मनी सीमा अर्न यू आर हियर मनी सीमा अर्न इज इक्वल टू व्हाट मनी सीमा अर्न इज इक्वल टू हियर गिवेन रुपीज 1,50,000। क्लियर, मनी सीमा अर्न इज 1,50,000 रुपीज। मनी सीमा सेव्स what amount of money saved by Seema Seema saves this is equal to what money Seema saves is equal to ₹50,000। okay, ₹50,000 Seema saved and what is amount of money that Seema spent? Okay, so money spent Seema or money spent by Seema money spent by Seema or Seema money Seema spent what amount of money Seema spent? So we subtract earning money by Seema and saved money by Seema. So what is earning money? Earning money of Seema is 1,50,000 rupees and she saves ₹50,000. Clear? The money, amount of money spent by Seema is equal to amount of money earned by Seema minus amount of money saved by Seema. This is equal to what? This is equal to, you can see, if you subtract 50,000 from 1,50,000, then you obtain what? 1,00,000 rupees. Then you obtain 1,00,000 rupees. This is clear? So 1,00,000 rupees money spent by Seema per years. Then in this question, this is given that in a year, Seema earn 1,50,000 rupees and saves 50,000 rupees. Okay, so we need to find the ratio of money that Seema earn to the money she saves. Okay, this is a part of this question. Ratio of in first part this is given find the ratio of money that Seema earn ratio of money that Seema earn and to money that Seema earns to the money to the money to the money that Seema spent to the money that Seema spent okay clear So in this question you can see that Seema saves, not spend. First question is find the ratio of the money that Seema earns to the money that Seema saves. Okay. So here Seema earns money is rupees, not rupees, you write only 1,50,000. Rupees 1,50,000 rupees. Okay, 1,50,000. This is earned by Seema in 1 year. And she saves how many amount? Only 50,000. Okay, so you need to find the ratio of money that Seema earns to the money that Seema saves. So here 1,50,000 rupees is the money that Seema earns in 1 year, and 50,000 rupees, 50,000 rupees she saves. Okay, so if you can see 1,02,340, 1,02,340, then we have 15/5. Also, you can write, you can divide 5 by 5, and 5 3 15. 5 by 5, 5 3 15. Then you have 3/1. So you can write it. This is equal to 3:1. Okay. So in this question, this is given that Seema earns 1,50,000 rupees in a year, and she saves only 50,000 rupees. So how many amount of money she spent? Then we subtract 1,50,000 from we subtract 50,000 from 1,50,000. We obtain here 1,00,000. So money spent by Seema is 1,00,000 rupees. Okay. So first you find the ratio of money that Seema earns to the money that Seema saves. So in this way you can see here 1,50,000 by 50,000. This is equal to, you can write, if you can see 4,0 by 0, then you obtain here 15/5, or you can say 3/1. Clear? Or also we can write 3:1. Student, I hope all of you understood this A part. Now we are going to solve B part of this question. B part is that find the ratio of money that she saves to the money she spend. Okay, saves to spend. In this part we find money earned to saves, and B part we find the ratio saves to spend. So let's see how to find the ratio of money that Seema saves to the money that she spends. Okay, so this is B part. We find in B part ratio of money that Seema saves to ratio of money that Seema saves to the money she spends. To the money she spends. She spends means Seema spends. Okay. So here you can see a save money is 50,000 rupees. We are saying 50,000. And spend money is 1,00,000 rupees. 1,00,000 rupees. Okay. Save money is 50,000 rupees and spend money is 1,00,000 rupees. So you can cancel 4,0. 1,2,3,4. 1,2,3,4. 4,0 from 4,0 in numerator and denominator both. So you get here 5/10. 5/10 means 5 by 5, 5 by 10. 1/2. So ratio is equal to 1/2 is equal to 1:2. So in this way you can see here the ratio of money that Seema earns, that Seema saves to the money she spends is ratio 1:2. This is clear. See, in both parts, in first part we find the ratio of money debt sigma earn to debt sigma saves. This is equal to 1:3. And in B part, we find the ratio of money debt sigma saves to the money C spend. This is equal to 1:2. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Now, next question, question number 9. What have in question number 9? In question number 9, this is given, there are 102 teachers in a school of 3,300 students. How many teachers? 102 teachers and 3,300 students. Find the ratio of number of teacher to the number of students. So let's see, total students is given here 3,300 and number of teachers is given here 102. So let's see how to find the ratio of 102 to 3,300. Okay, so first we erase it. Okay, so in question number 8, this is given and that sigma earn in a year 1,50,000 rupees and C saves only 50,000 rupees and C spend 1,00,000 rupees. So we need to find the ratio of earning money to save money. This is equal to 3:1. And in B part, we need to find the ratio of save money to spend money. This is equal to 1:2. Okay, now we are going to solve question number 9. This is side 12.21. What happened question number 9? Total teachers is equal to number of teachers. Okay, this is given. Number of teachers. Number of teacher is equal to, this is given, 102 in a school. Okay, and total number of student, total number of student is equal to 3,300. Clear? In this question, this is given. In a school, have 102 teachers and 3,300 students. So we need to find the ratio of number of teachers to the number of students. Okay? So we find ratio of number of teacher to the number of students. Okay. Ratio of number of teachers to the number of students. This is equal to what? So number of teachers is equal to 102 by 3,300. Okay. So both are divisible by 3 and 2 both. So first we divide it at 3. Okay. So if you divide it 3, so you have to hear 3 is 9 and 3 4 is 12. Okay? And it's become 3 1 3 3 1 3 3 1 3 3 1 3 11. 1,100. Again, you can divide it by 2. If you divide it by 2, see, you have to hear 17. And here 5. This is clear? Now, this is simplified. This is the prime number 17, and this number is not divisible by 550, is not divisible by 17. So this is the simplest form of these numbers, 102 by 3300. So the required speed is equal to what? 17,550. Okay. So student, in this question, this is given that the number of teachers in a school is 102 and the number of students in a school is 3300. So we need to find the ratio of number of teachers to number of students. This is equal to 102 by 3300. This is equal to 17 by 550. Or you can write, this is equal to 17:550. Now, student, I hope all of you understood these questions. Now, we are going to discuss next question, question number 10. In question number 10, this is given that in a college, out of 4,320 students, 2,300 are girls. Find the ratio of number of girls to the number total number of the students. Okay, so number of girls is given here 2,300, and number total student is also given here 4,320. Okay, and next, find the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls. So let's see how to find the number of boys to the number of girls. Okay, so firstly, it is there. In question number 10, this is given the total strength of a college. And the number of girls is also given 2,300. And total strength of the college given here 4,320. So when you subtract number of strength from total strength of college, then we obtain number of boys. Okay, so in question number 10, we can write here total student in a college. Okay, total number of student, that is total number of students. This is equal to what? This is equal to given here 4,320. Okay, total number of students is given here 4,320. And number of students, number of girls. In students, both have present number girls and boys. So number of girls is given here. Number of girls is equal to what? Number of girls is equal to 2,300. Okay, this is given. Now, so here we need to find number of boys because question asked to us find the ratio of number of girls to the number of boys. Okay, so write here number of boys, number of boys is equal to what? Number of boys is equal to total number of students minus number of girls. When you subtract 2,300 from 4,320, then you obtain number of boys. So you can write here 4,320 minus 2,300. Okay, this is total number of students in a college. This is the number of girls. Okay, so you can use this method to find the subtraction. 4,320 minus 2,300. Okay, so here this becomes 0. 0 minus 0, 0. 2 minus 0 is equal to 2. Now, 3 minus 3 is equal to 0. 4 minus 2 is equal to 2. Okay, so here you can see the number of boys is equal to 2,020. Number of boys equal to what? Number of boys equal to 2,020. This is the number of boys in a school. Okay. In this question, this is given that in a school, sorry, in a college, total number of students is 4,320 320 and number of girls is also given 2300. So first you find and find the ratio of number of girls to the number of boys. So first you find the number of boys. How can you find the number of boys? We will subtract the number of girls from the total student of the on a school college, then we obtain the number of boys. So total student in college is 4320 and number of girls is 2300. When you subtract this, then you find 2020. This is the number of boys in schools. Now the first question arises here. Find the ratio of number of girls to the total number of students. Find the ratio to the number of girls to total number of students. So let's see, ratio of number of girls, this is a part, ratio of number of girls, number of girls at two, ratio of number of girls to the total number of students, two and the total number of students. This is equal to that. Number of girls given here 2300 and total number of students given here 4320. So first you can cancel this 0 by 0. Then you have 10 here, 230 by 432. Clear? After this again we simplify it. Again we simplify it. You can divide it by 2. So it's become 2 1 ja 2 again 2 1 ja 2 2 1 ja 2 2 5 ja, and here if you cut by 2 we obtain 2 2 ja 4 2 1 ja 2 2 6. This is clear now. So instead you find 115 by 116. Clear? 115 by 216. This is clear? Now, so 115 and 216 have no count factor except 1. So our required ratio of number of boys to the number of girls is equal to what? We can write here 1 ratio 15 and 2 ratio 16. This is clear? So student, I hope all have understood these questions. Now we are going to discuss B part. Okay? What have in B part? B part have find the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls. Okay, so let's see what is the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls. Here you can see the number of boys is 2020 and number of girls is 2300. So in B part we need to find so number of boys. We find in B part a ratio of number of boys to the number of girls, number of girls is equal to the ratio of number of boys. So number of boys is equal to 2020 by number of girls is equal to 2300. Clear? number of boys is equal to 2020 and number of girls is equal to 2300. So first you can cancel it like this, okay, and 0 by 0, or you can say divide both numerator and denominator by 10, then you get 202 and 230. Again you can divide the numerator and denominator by 2, then you obtain, if you divide this by 2, you obtain 101 and this obtain 150. Then your fraction is, the smallest fraction is 101 by 150. Clear? So the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls, this is equal to 101 ratio 150. Okay, so in this question this is given that total number of students is 4320. This is given, and also given the number of students and number of girls is 2300. So we need to find first number of boys. So we subtract the number of girls from the total strength of the college, then you get 2020. This is the number of boys in the college. Okay, so here we need to find the number of ratio. We need to find the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls. So number of boys is equal to 2020 by number of girls is equal to 2300. So first you cancel 0 by 0, then here you obtain 202 by 230. Again you divide both numerator and denominator by 2, then we obtain 101 by 115. So this is the required ratio, 101 ratio 115. Okay, so you can say the ratio of number of boys to the number of girls is 101 ratio 115. This is clear. Now we are going to discuss next part of this question, C part is that find the ratio of number of boys to the total number of student in the college. Okay, so let's see, we need next part, we need to find ratio of number of boys to the number of student, total number of student. Okay, in the college total number of students is given 4320. Okay, so in C part we need to find a ratio of number of boys to the number of boys to the number of student, number of total student. Okay, to the number of total students, ratio of number of boys to the number of total student in the college, student. Okay, so total number of boys given here 2020, here number of boys you find, and total number of student is given. What is the total number of student? This is given. Total number of student in the college is 4320. So you can cancel here 0 by 0. Then we obtain 202 by 432. Okay. So here you observe that in both numerator and denominator, what is common? 2 is common. If you divide it by 2, then you obtain 2 1 2 0 2 1 2. Again this 2 2 4 2 1 2 2 6. So you obtain here 101 by 216. Okay, so what is the required ratio? Required ratio is equal to 101 ratio 260. Okay, so you can say Did Rishu have number of wives? The number of total student in the college is 101, Rishu 216. So student, I hope all of you understood this question. Thank you for watching. Jai Hind.